हेलो
This conference will now be recorded.
हेलो
इसे ओपन
गाइस, आर यू एबल टू हियर माय वॉइस? आर यू एबल टू सी माय स्क्रीन?
यस.
या गुड. ओके, so can just someone tell me what exactly we discussed in the last session? You remember or forgotten? Yes. Yeah, the session is recording. So, can you just tell me what exactly we discussed in the last session? Satish or Prabhu? Abhinaya? Chanakya? Matthew?
About activities.
Exactly, we were discussing about the activities, right? Even in the activities, how to pass the parameters. Okay, so all those things. And so I think, yes, in the last session, we had some issue with one of the property, right? Like when we select the checkbox of present address same as the permanent address. Okay, so the address, city, state, and country has to be disabled to something like that. So, what is the flow? Customer details. Actions run. Okay. So, in this screen, we were. So when you select this checkbox, these fields are disabled, right? But the country was not disabling. Still, still it is having the same problem. Okay. So what could be the reason of this? So what is the section? Customer home address, right? Yeah, here you go. So here for the country, it is not working. So here it is having some problem like, okay, in 7.4. When the control is inherited from property, okay, when the control is inherited from property, this disable is not working exactly. So what is this control inherited from property? Is anyone remember? Satish or anyone? So generally for all other properties, what will be there? The control, how you want to display it, like whether it is a text box or drop down or radio buttons, something like this, right? Okay, we can select this. Otherwise, what exactly we can apply? Revert to the property default. So what do you mean by property default? For the city, okay, at the property level, what we have applied, okay, here the UX control, that will be taken, right? Otherwise, we can also update it. Okay, so right now we changed it to the text input instead of from the city. Okay, instead of this control, okay, we have updated in the section. Okay, to the text input. But whereas for the country, we have given control inherited from property. Means at the property, whatever we have declared, that will be applied. So instead of that, okay, you can apply text input again here. Okay, you can apply the text input, something like this. So when you apply the text input, it is working fine. But when you apply the control from the property, then it is having the problem. So this problem is occurring only in the 7.4 version. Okay, so there is a defect from the Pega itself. Okay, so they are going to give the fix for that. So once if you install that fix, then it will work on it. Okay, then this issue will be resolved. Okay, right now for us, okay, we can have the text input and we can see whether it will work or not. So there is no problem or no issue with the coding. Why? Because we have applied the same disable condition. Disable condition and again the condition. Otherwise, for the city we have applied disable condition and then the when rule. Okay, this is the when rule we have selected. The same thing we have applied for the country property and it is not working. Okay, so why it is not working is it's because of the Pega 7.4. okay, and even here if you apply the text input and now the disable when rule and then client address same as permanent address and then submit it, save it. Okay, now when you run the flow, now if you select the checkbox, see now the country also disabled along with the city and again address. Got it, right? Okay, yeah, that is the one thing. And the next thing is like, okay, if you see this work object, this is the work object. Okay, it has created with H-44. Okay, so along these are the properties which we have placed in the work object. Okay, these are the properties which we have placed in the work object. But along with that right side, okay, we will be seeing some information like case details, last updated by. So the operator who created this and who updated by, that information you can see here. So now I logged in as a developer one. Okay, I logged in as a developer one. So we can see the operator here, right? See. This is the developer one and the full name is developer. Okay, so this is the way, and once if you create any of the work object, the work object is created by whom and the last updated by, okay, that will be information will be displayed here. Okay, and along with that open assignments. Okay, currently on which assignments we have. Okay, so if you see the customer details flow, okay, so right now I am on the first screen, right? The what is the first screen? That is the customer details. Okay, that is the customer details. So and when you move to the second screen, it will display vehicle details. Okay, it will display vehicle details. Let's see whether it will update it or not. Submit. Now we have come to the vehicle details. So whenever you come to the vehicle details, so assignment it will be changed accordingly. Okay, open assignment. Assignment. Okay, why it is showing the assignment? Why? Because for this assignment we did not give any label. Okay, so here at the assignment, okay, the default text it is having is assignment. So that is the reason why it is showing. So whatever the thing text you will be giving here, vehicle details. Now if you select submit, okay, and then save it. Now again run the flow. So at which assignment you are working, that assignment label will be displayed. Okay, here you go. Right now current details. Sorry, customer details, and then if you select submit, now the open assignment will be vehicle details, you see. Okay, so the operator name and again the assignment on which assignment you are working. Okay, again that is the operator. Okay, so here something called followers, that means if there are multiple operators working on it, that will display here. And even if you have any attachments also, it will be displayed here. Okay, where are the attachments for this work object? Okay, like as I said that, okay, any person applies for the personal loan. Okay, so we'll be adding the address proof, maybe we'll be adding the salary details, pay slips and all those things. So all this information, all those attachments you can add here. So you can select add attachment. Okay, file from device or URL. Okay, URL means okay, like okay, gmail.com or something like you can give. Otherwise, if the file is in your computer, then you can select file from device. Okay, it will open the attachment dialog box. Okay, we can either drag and drop the file, otherwise we can select the file. Okay, see here. So from your computer, you can attach any of the file here. Like this. Once if you attach, okay, the name of the file will be displayed here. Okay, likewise in the work object, okay, while creating the work object, we can add the attachments and even the participants again. It is also the same thing like, okay, who is working on the work object. And in case if you don't want this file again, you can delete it. Or else even you can download it to the local system again so that the attachment will be deleted permanently. Are you sure you want to continue? Submit. Yes, it's got deleted. So likewise, the work object information will be displayed here. The operator, okay, the current assignment and the total number of the participants and then attachments, okay, everything. And even here, these are the properties you placed, but here you see seeing cancel button, save button, submit button. Okay, these are the PRPC default buttons which will come automatically. When you create the work object, these are the default buttons, cancel, save, and submit. Okay, so what is the difference between save and submit? Submit means it moves to the next screen, but whereas save means it will just save the data to the DB. Okay, it will just save the data to the DB and then it will not move to the next screen. So you can still further proceed it. See, still you are on the same page when you select the save button, but when you select the submit button, it will finish the current assignment. Okay, current assignment means this vehicle details flow action will be finished and it will go to the next one. So here it is having flow end, so the work object will be finished. Okay, in case if you are on the customer details, there if you select the save button, it will save the data and it will be in the same assignment. Okay, that is the same user interface, that is the customer details. Okay, so likewise we can create the work objects and we can move further. Okay, this is the information about the case details. Okay, the next thing, so here what I want to do is, okay, I want to see what are the records or else what are the rules checked out by me. Okay, what are the rules checked out by me, I wanted to see. So currently, if you see this customer home address, is it checked in or checked out? Satish.
Yes.
So currently, it is in checked out or checked in?
It's in a checked out.
Exactly. So I did checked out. Okay, so I'm able to do the changes in the screen, right? I'm able to do the changes. Okay, I can do the changes and then I can save it, right? I can save it. So how you can say that whether it is checked out? Here it is showing check-in. Check-in means already it is checked out, so it is the check-in button is enabled. Okay, so in the same way, how many number of the rules are checked out by me? Okay, if you want to see how many number of the rules checked out by me, how you can see means here just beside the search text box, you have something called tick mark. So this tick mark, if you click on it will show you the total number of the rules. See, these all are the rules are checked out by me currently. Okay, by me currently. So copy present to permanent. See, this is also one of the activity checked out by me. So in general, what you have to do is whenever you perform any action, okay, whenever you complete your task on any of the rule, like whether it is a section, otherwise it is a flow, otherwise it is an activity, so you immediately need to check in. Okay, then only your changes will be committed to the database, and then these rules are available for the other operators to work on it. Okay, so otherwise, if you leave it like this, and if you go home, if anybody, any other operator wants to work on this activity, what will happen? It will show the message to the user saying this rule is checked out by Satish. So he cannot work on it. He cannot do the changes. So as a best practice, whenever you are leaving home, or still better performance is, better thing is, whenever you complete your task on any of the rule, immediately you check in by giving the valid comments. Implemented functionality for copying the values, copying the data from present to permanent address like this. So now I did check in of this rule. Now if you select all the rules checked out by this tick mark, now it will not show that. See, copy present to permanent address. Earlier it was showing that. Now it is not showing that. Okay, likewise. So whenever you perform any of the functionality, whenever you implement the functionality, you can do the check-in. And if you want to see the rules, the complete rules checked out by you, you can select the tick mark. Now I checked in when rule also. If you see the list, see now when rule has moved out of the list. Okay. Vehicle details. So under the vehicle details, what are the actions I have done? Under the actions tab, we have applied the populate state. That is the thing. Okay, now let me see. So as I said that today we would like to discuss about the tracer. Okay, so till now we learned two of the debugging tools. So what are the debugging tools till now we learned? Something called clipboard and live UI. So today we are going to learn about the tracer. So what is this tracer? Okay, when we have this live UI and clipboard, why we have to go for the tracer? So live UI means when you run the work object, okay, we can see in the user interface what is the property name, and this property is available in which section, and this section is available in which fashion. Okay, like that we used to see. I hope everyone remember. So this is the work object, right? So in this work object, okay, if you want to see this city is available in which layout, which section and which fashion, then we'll use in the live UI. So when you select the live UI, and then if you move the pointer to the any of the property, okay, so in the right side hierarchy, we'll be seeing this. This is the city property, and this city is available in which this dynamic layout. Okay, even in the work object also it is highlighting. Okay, this dynamic layout is available in which section? Customer home address. And this customer home address is available where? Under the customer details container. And this customer details container is available where? In customer details flashing. Right? This customer details flashing. So till now we have created. And even by default, it is again under the part of the section in SL non-auto generator. This is again part of the PEGA. So PI case action area header. See, this is the header of the work object. So likely this live UI we used for identifying, okay, in which section, which property, which flash, and it is there. Okay, So now the next thing, what? Okay, clipboard. So what is the purpose of the clipboard? So again, if you want to come out of the live UI, select the same option. Okay, and then the clipboard. Okay, in the clipboard, we used to see the complete pages in the cache, in the memory. Okay, so for this H-46 work object, by default, it has created these many number of the pages. But under this, right now, our work object information is stored on PY work page. Okay, under the PY work page, okay, we'll be having permanent address, present address, all these things values. Okay, so this is the clipboard. So under the clipboard, we'll be seeing the complete structure of the work object, all the pages, all the properties, all the values. Okay, now the third thing is the tracer. Okay, third one is the tracer. So what is this tracer? Okay, the tracer is nothing but it gives the work, it gives the step-by-step execution of the work object processing. Okay, it gives the step-by-step execution of the work object processing. Okay, so once if you select this, it will open a pop-up window. Okay, here it is pop-up blog, so enable it. Now if you click on the tracer again, now you see it will open a pop-up window. Okay, in this pop-up window, this is the tracer window. So it shows the complete work object execution of the step-by-step. Tracer is used for watch the step-by-step execution of the work object processing. So we can see which step it is executing first and later which step and later which step. So all these complete information we can see here. So how we can see? Okay, so before seeing that, okay, I just wanted to let you know the options available in the tracer. Okay, the options. Okay, here we have something called pass. That means if you pass it, okay, even though you perform the work object processing, it will not show it here. Okay, it will not display here. Okay, and in case if you select clear, if it is showing anything, it will be cleared. Okay, let's see an example and let me explain it. So now I have started it, play. Okay, so after playing it, okay, now go to the designer studio. See, as I told you, this is a pop-up window, tracer, and this is our designer studio. Okay, pop-up window and designer studio. So in the pop-up window, tracer. Okay, in the designer studio, actual work object which we will be performing. Okay, now after starting, see it is running. So pass, and even in the down also you can see that it is tracing. Okay, here also you can see that it is tracing. Okay, so this tracing and now pass. Pass indicates already it is running. So now go to the designer studio, select the flow and then actions and then run. So when you run it, you see automatically in the tracer, see it is giving that, okay, complete steps it is giving one by one. See, like this is the complete list of the tracer execution work object processing. Okay, that means when the work object has created, what all are the rules executed, you can see here. What are all the rules created? What are all the rules executing? It is displaying here. So as I said that, okay, in case even though I perform some action, if you don't want to show it here, right now 99. Okay, and then if you pass, okay, now if you perform any action, like I'm going to the next screen, submit. It will not load anything. Still, it is on the 99. Why? Because I stopped it. Tracing stopped. Okay, it's in the pause mode. Okay, again, if you play it, then only again it will trace it. You see, from 99, see 126, you got it. 125, 153, 163. Likewise. So, whenever it is executing the work object, so the complete steps will be loaded here. Okay, so And how exactly you can see them? You can go down, you can see from one also again. So I made it zoom so that you can see it bigger. So the complete steps, first step. Okay, so if you scroll down like this, then you can see from very beginning to the till now. So the total, how many are there? In case if you want, you can decrease the zoom like this. 100% again, I kept it. So, and then in case if you want to clear this, okay, I want to start the fresh processing. So clear it. So once if you clear, you see, again, it's gone. Now go to the work object again, go to the flow and again, actions and then run. See, again, it is still showing the work object processing step by step. Okay, so pass means stop and clear means clear it. Okay, and then settings. So what is the settings? So right now, okay, here we are seeing the step-by-step execution, right? Okay, even under the step-by-step execution also, okay, we can see the line numbers. So the total 99 lines it is showing and the thread, okay, which is the current thread. Okay, that means which is the current work object kind of the thing. Okay, and then int, okay, so and then rule number. Okay, and then step method. So this int and rule number, it's not mandatory, just ignore that. Okay. Mainly we can concentrate on step method. Okay, step method, stream end, stream begin. Stream means the section which it is displaying. Stream means here the section. Okay, stream rules are nothing but the user interface rules. Okay, stream rules are nothing but the user interface rules. Okay, so currently stream begin, stream end. Okay, means it is loading the section. Okay, and then the step page. Step page is nothing but your work object page. Okay, your work object page. And then event type. Okay, what is this event type? This is also almost same as the step method. Okay, stream rules, stream begin end. Okay, stream rules. In case if it is an activity, here you can see the activity begin, activity end. So we have used something called populate state. I hope everyone remember for loading the state values. Okay, for loading the state values, we created an activity populate state, right? So the populate state is an activity. So in this, we used something called obj browse method for loading the clipboard page. Okay, the clipboard page is states page. So from the states page only, we have populated the states value. So here we can see the activity begin, activity end. Okay, even under the activity also, okay, here you have something called step and status. Okay, step, status and event type. Generally for the stream rules, you will not be having any step or status. But if it is an activity, okay, so it will show you the step number and then whether it is good or bad. That means here, how many steps we have in an activity? Right now we have only one step. Okay, if we have multiple steps, okay, so the list of the steps which it is executing, we can see it here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, something like that. And even after executing this step, okay, if there is any error, then we can see that error message. Okay, whether this step is executing successfully or not, good or fail. So like that also, we can see it here. And so here, in case if you want to see some kind of the error. So in case if this step is not executing properly, then it will show you that error. Okay, not the design time, runtime errors. If at all any error, that error also it will show you in the tracer. So in the tracer, step begin, step end. Okay, step begin and step end. So it has started the step, and then after completing this work object processing, then it will give you step end. Okay, in case if you want to see, okay, what exactly it contains, the step begin and step end, you can select that. Okay, under the step begin again, it will give you the more information like, okay, so when it has started, who created, all this information, the which class, okay, work object ID, and all this information like when it has executed, the date and time, whether it is a step begin or step end like that. Okay, when it reaches to that particular step, it will give step begin, and when it reaches to the ending, it will give the step end. And so here, okay, have you seen here one more thing? We have something called rule set. Okay, we have something called rule set. So what is this rule set? Our version and again the rule set. Okay, HDFC insurance implementation, and then the version where we are creating this rule. Okay, so HDFC insurance implementation, okay, our rule set. Then what is this UI-kit? So this UI-kit is one of the rule set again created by Pega. So that is used for displaying the strings. As I said, okay, in the work object, along with our own section, it contains lot of other sections, right? So when you see the live UI, okay, as I said, okay, along with our customer details, okay, so along with the customer details, we have something called PY case action area, okay? So it has highlighted PY case action area, this is that, okay, and PY case action header, so this is that. So likewise, there are n number of the sections available on top of our sections. So where this section is available, okay, where this section is available, in case if you open that section, okay, so then you can see that on which rule set it is available. See here, UI-kit. Okay, UI-kit. So likewise, when it is loading, okay, when the work object is loading, it will display PY case action header also. So this PY case attachments wrapper, all these PY case attachments, okay, PY case error section, all these things, okay, is available in Pega default rule set, that is UI-kit. Okay, UI-kit 7. So like this, UI-kit-7, and the version is 11.1.1. Okay, so generally when the work object is processing, I don't want to see the Pega rule sets. Okay, I don't want to see the Pega rule sets. I wanted to trace only the rule sets which I have created. And I want to trace only the rules which I have created, not the Pega default rules. So in that case, what you can do is now you can go to the settings. Okay, under the settings, now you can see which rules you wanted to trace. Okay, all these you can select here. So I wanted to trace, okay, events to trace in this activity steps, data transform actions, exceptions, when rules. So likewise, you can select which rules you wanted to trace while work object is processing. Okay, so if you don't want to trace, okay, data transform, I will tell you about this also. This is also one of the rule like activity. As I said, in Pega, everything is a rule. Okay, we have flow action, section, okay, property, and the activities, right? In the same way, we have something called data transform. Okay, we will discuss about this later. Okay, so in case if you don't want to trace them, okay, you can remove the checkboxes. If you don't want to trace the when rule also, you can remove the checkbox. And along with that, okay, we have so many other things, event types to trace. Okay, so what are that? Okay, like flow, okay, other rules, flow, queue processing, okay, parse rules, okay, interaction, declare trigger. Okay, these all are the various types of the rules. Okay, these all are the various types of the rules. So you can select which rules you wanted to trace, and you can remove the unwanted rules. And then, Along with that, as I said, okay, I don't want to trace the PEGA rule sets. Okay, I don't want to trace the PEGA rule sets. So here, rule sets to trace. It will show you the complete list of the rule sets available in your application. Okay, complete list of the rules available in your application. So HDFC, this developer one at hdfc.com. Okay, HDFC INT, HDFC insurance integration. Okay, all these are rule sets created by me. Okay, we have created this. Okay, and then, okay, along that, the PEGA rules, UI-kit, PEGA process commander, PEGA deployment defaults. So all these things are the default rule sets available. Okay, so if you want to trace them also, all, then you can select all. So all the rule sets has been selected. In case if you don't want to trace all these rule sets, why? Because there is no use of tracing the PEGA rule sets, PEGA rules. Why? Because their functionality is already tested and it is working fine. So you cannot find anything with them. So you will be doing the mistakes on your rule sets, on your rules. So select only the rules which you have created. So deselect all and select only these rule sets. And then select OK. Now clear it. Now trace it by creating some other work object. And closing the existing work objects. Okay, now go to customer details and then run the flow. Okay, now if you go to tracer, see, this time very few number of the events it is showing. Okay, in that also, you can see only the rules which you have created. Okay, so what is the first rule? The flow start. So what is that flow name? Here you can see that customer details. Okay, here in the name, you can see the rule along with the class in which it is available. Okay, so customer details flow under the class HDFC insurance work. So in this class it is there. And then, okay, here we can see the next one here, the work list. Okay, and then again here, the customer details flow. Okay, so how you can know that what is the rule it is? So you can see it here in the flow. Okay, flow rule, flow connector, flow route start. Flow route end, okay, and then flow idle, and then the populate state. So this populate state is an activity. So this activity has started execution, so begin, and then in which class it is available. Okay, and after that here you can see the rule set. Okay, so here what is the rule set? HDFC insurance implementation. Then what is this again? Developer one at hdfc.com. What is this newly we are hearing, developer one at hdfc.com?
Check in or check out option.
Exactly. So currently this populate state is in checked out. So when you check out this any rule set, okay, how you can see that? Okay, instead of the rule set name, okay, it will take your operator ID. Okay, instead of that, but when you check in it, okay, then it will not be showing developer one. Okay, so for example, now populate state, right? The populate state, I did check in. Okay, so once if you check in, okay, right now, how many number of the steps it is showing in the tracer? 21, right? Total 21 steps it is showing. Okay, they are the rules which I have created. Okay, populate state it is showing developer one. Now let me create, I'm not clearing this. Okay, so here I'm not clearing, but I'm creating one more work object. Actions, run. Okay, so here, now if you go to tracer, see, previous details are there as it is, and at the same time now, the second work object details also got it here. Earlier we have 21, okay, now 42. Okay, that means from 22nd onwards, the new work object details. Okay, and let's come to the point. So Poplet state, earlier it was in developer one at hdfc.com, but now Poplet state at HDFC insurance implementation rule set. That means if any rule is checked out by you, okay, that rule operator ID will be displayed. Okay, but once if you check in that, okay, it will show you the actual rule set on which it is checked in. Okay, and the one which it has been executed. Okay, like that. So the activity, and then under the activity, step one, okay, under the step one begin, and then step one end, and then activity end. Okay, and then it is loading the section which we have created, customer details. So this customer details is a section. As I told you, every user interface rule is a stream rule. So it will show you as a stream rule. Okay, like this. And then flow start. As I said, this is the second work object steps started. Okay, and then again, flow idle, flow start, and flow route, all these things. Okay, so and then the populate state, it has loaded the state's property values, and then again the section. So like this, we can see the complete list of the steps. Each and every step execution we can see in the tracer, and it's loading from which rule set. Okay, so here the populate state is from the HDFC insurance implementation 010102, but here customer office address, it is loading from 010101. Okay, why it is taking from 010101? Why it is not taking from 010102?
Because we didn't save it in second version.
Exactly. So for this rule, we don't have in the 010102. I did not do any changes after 010101. So if you do save as and if you do any changes, then it will pick up from the higher version. But if it is not there in the higher version, it will take from the lower version itself. Got it, right? Okay, if any rule is available in the higher version, then it will take from the higher version. Else it will take from the lower version itself. Okay, for this rule, it is not available on the higher version. And even if you want to see, okay, so whether this version is having in the higher or not. Okay, how you can see it? Okay, generally, as I said, if you want to open any rule, we can also do search. So select the name of the rule, and then in the search button, type customer office address. And after giving the name of the rule, press enter key. Okay, it will show you if the rule is available. See, customer office address. So from here also, we can open the rule as I said. Okay, for example, I want to open customer office address 1. Okay, and then I am pressing enter key. Okay, so if you press enter key, it is showing that no matching search results found. That means there is no section, there is no rule with the customer office address 1. So give the correct rule name, press enter key, then we can see the name of the rule. Okay, so here it is showing it is a section, and then this is the name of the rule. And it is available in under the class applies to class. Okay, and along with the section, you have something called expand row. Okay, when you select this expand row, then you can see on which version of the rule set this rule is available. This rule is available under the rule set HDFC insurance implementation 010101. And this rule is created by admin at hdfc.com 17 days ago. Okay, and the availability is yes, yes, we can use this rule. Okay, so this rule set, as I said, this section is available only under the 010101. Okay, can you tell me any of the rule which is available in both the versions? Populate state. type this and press enter key. Now you see, this is the activity type rule. The name of the rule is populate state, and then this is under the applies to class. Okay, now if you expand it, okay, now as I said, if you expand this option, okay, now you can see the complete list of the rule sets along with their versions in which this activity existing. See, this populate state is available only in 010102. I did not create it in 010101. So it is showing only 010102. Okay, now let's take any other rule which exists in both the versions. So I hope everyone is understanding. Populate state is available only in 010102. Okay, customer office address is available only in 010101. Now let's give customer details. Now it will list out again all the rules. Oh my god, these many number of the rules are there with customer details. Okay, so the class name also customer details, the flow also collect customer details and customer details. There is a flow action, collect customer details and customer details. And there is a section, collect customer details, contact information, customer details container. So these many number of the rules available with the customer details. And it is not only showing the exact customer details, it is also showing if the rule name contains collect customer details, it is showing that. Okay. And in case if you want to see only exact match rules, then here you have something called, see, contains this search criteria, exact match or else starts with. If you select exact match, see, it will display only the rules which are having the name as a customer details. Only one flow and one flow action is there. Okay. Now let's expand flow. When you expand the flow, again it will show you in which rule sets this flow is available. See, it's available under the 010101 and 010102. Okay, and then developer1@hdfc.com. Why? Because it is in checked out by me. So it is showing even the current version. Okay, under the developer one. Okay. So like this, we can see all the versions. And if you want to open any of the version, you can click on that particular version. Then it will open that rule. See, I have opened customer details under 010101. This is the flow. But which is already checked out by me is this one. If you select this, see, this is the change. Flow end vehicle details. This is the old version under the 010101. Okay, this is the latest one on checked out by my operator ID. Okay, in case if you want to see any reference kind of thing, okay, then you can go for this old version and you can see that, okay, what are the changes are done. So what are the changes available? So like this, you can understand the checked out versions as well. Okay, got it guys? Any doubts? So to open any of the rule, we can search with the name. Okay, once if you give the name and press the enter key, it will search it. And after searching, it will list out all the rules available with that name of the rule. Okay, and even in that also, if you want, you can do exact match. Otherwise it contains or else it starts. If you select starts with, okay, it will show you again all the rules which are beginning with the customer details. So customer details container, one more section is there. but in the name, anywhere it may contain. Then you can see more than, okay, as these all are having customer details in that flows. So collect customer details. After collect, it is there. Okay. And if you want to open any of the rule, if you select the flow action, directly it will open the higher version. Okay. Remember one more thing. If you select customer details, by default, it will open the higher version. Higher version means from 010102. Okay. In case if you want to open the lower version, then what you have to do?
Expand it and select.
Exactly. So you can expand that row and then you can see all the versions. From there again, you can select whichever you wanted to open the flow like this. So there are totally three versions, 010101, 010102, and then again, one is checked out by me. Okay. One is checked out by me. So out of three, again, whichever you wanted to open, you can just select that rule and it will open it like this. Right. So in the same way, even in the tracer also, okay, so you can see which version of the rule it is picking up. Okay, populate states is picking up from the 010102. Okay, and then it is under the class. And then, okay, if it is the activity, we can see the step number as well. And step begin, step end. Okay, whether that step is successfully completed or any error. And then activity begin, activity end. And then stream rule. Stream rule means user interface rules. And again, if it is a flow, it will give flow start. Okay. So like that, the complete step-by-step execution of the work of the processing, you can see. And then where exactly it is processing, the step page name. So the PY work page. Okay. And then the step method. Okay. Mainly in the activity, it is useful. Okay. In the activity, what is the step method? OBJ browse. Okay, so even if you go to the activity and if you see what is the method we performed the OBJ browse method. Okay, that it will display in the tracer step method. Okay, so these are the things. And then if you want to see the values of the page, so previously we used to see on the clipboard. Right, in the clipboard, we can open the PY work page. Under the PY work page, what are the values it contains under the properties, we can be able to see it. But here, even in the tracer also, we can see which property contains which value. So the PY work page, we can select it. Okay, and here also you can see the values of the properties. It gives the complete list, not only your properties, okay, everything about the work object. Okay, we can see on the clipboard. And the same thing on the tracer as well. Like this. Okay, so even as I said, okay, what are the rule types you want to select, you wanted to trace, events to trace, here also, where different rules it is showing, here only activities, data transforms, when rules, okay, here again, you have flows, flow actions, and all other rules, stream rules, okay, stream rules means it will take the complete list of the UI, okay, UI related rules. Okay, like section, flow action, harness, and all those things. Okay. And then again, we can select the rule sets also, which you wanted to trace it. Okay, and at a time, how many number of the events you wanted to see? 5,000. That means you can see the 5,000 steps at a time, you can see it. In case if you want to decrease or increase also, you can do it. Okay, 500. Okay, and the next thing is, okay, you can also have something called page name. Okay, that means if you want to trace only the PY work page, then also you can give it here. Now again, this is the old version from 010101, so I am closing it. Okay, and then this is from which version? 010102, but this is the checked out by me. And this is the 010102 version. Okay, from this version only I did checked out. Okay, from this version only I did checked out. And then actions. And then run it. Okay, now if you go to the tracer, okay, so it is not showing anything. Why? Because here there is no work objects. Okay, and then later, if you see, you can see only PY work page. But earlier, it was showing the so many things. Okay, now only PY work page related things, you can see it here. Like this, you can even add the step pages which you wanted to trace it. Okay, so this is the tracer. So anybody has any queries? Okay. Then let me go ahead. So not only work object processing, even for example, okay, when you are running an activity, right now populate state I am taking, okay, and how you can run? So select the action button and then run button, right? You see, even when you are running the activity, so here along with the run option, okay, you have trace and clipboard. As I said, we can select the clipboard here, we can also select here, and in the same way we can select tracer here and we can select trace here. Okay, but what is the difference between tracer here and trace option on the run of the activity? Means, okay, here this trace will only trace this activity. Okay, we'll only trace this activity. Now if you run this, you can only see the steps which are performed in the activity. See, only activity begin, activity end, nothing else. Okay, the trace current activity, this option is nothing but a trace current activity. But whereas tracer on the developer studio will trace the complete work object processing. Okay, it will trace the complete work object processing. But whereas in the tracer run rule, whereas in the tracer run rule, if you select the trace, okay, only that particular activity it will be executed. Okay, so even in the tracer now you can see activity begin, activity end, and in that there is a one step begin and step end, and then the activity which it is executing, and then the class on which that this activity is available. Okay, so the step, and again the step page name. Okay, the method, OBJ browse method. Okay, like this. And this is the thread standard, but earlier it was different for the work object, but one for the activity, when you run it independently, it will show you as a standard. Okay, the thread will be standard like this. Okay, and then again, the rule set from which version you are running this. Okay, so all this data, you can see it here. And then on the OBJ browse, if you select, on the end, okay, we can see again which operator is running, who is running it, the complete list again.
But why the threads are showing different from the two whole clipboard and this one?
This thread?
Yes.
This standard means now it is not a work object, right?
Yes.
Okay, when you run this activity from the work object, it is different, but it is standard. It's not W-40 or 50 or something like that. It is not related to any of the work object. If it is related to the project, then it is different. But when it is running independently, okay, then it is standard.
Okay.
Okay. Now I created one more activity also along with the populate state just for the testing purpose. Okay, I even did a check-in just some time back. Is anyone remember? Copy present to permanent. This is also I created. Okay. So in this activity, okay, I made comments. Right? Okay. And here also we did some kind of the copying. Okay, we did some kind of the copying, right? Okay, so here, okay, we also performed some kind of the parameters also. Quantity, price, and total like this. Okay, just for the testing, I have shown you. These are the parameter values. These are the local variables like that. Okay, local, under the local variable, we performed some kind of the action. Okay, so what is that? Okay, now let me check out. Okay, so here we did local.total equal to quantity into price. Okay, now actions. Run. Okay, here if you give something called quantity 20 and each one price is 10 rupees. Okay, each item price is 10 rupees. When you run this, okay, so where we can see these values? 10 into 20, how much? 30. Correct? How much? 200. Yeah, so these values where we can see, can we see it in the clipboard? Can we see it in the clipboard? No,
no, because we those quantity values only it will hold in clipboard.
We also where in the clipboard? Now I have opened the clipboard. In the clipboard. So generally work object information you can see on the clipboard, but these parameter values and then these local variables you cannot see on the clipboard. You can only see in the tracer, either the parameter values or else the local variables. You can only see in the tracer. So when you are running, keep the tracer. Okay, and then run it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now if you go to the tracer, you can see the steps as you all know. Okay, as I already told you, you can see the step by step. Okay, now here we did property set. You see, this is the third step. Okay, in the activity, copy present to permanent. Okay, the step number is 3. Okay, why it is showing only 3? Why not 1 and 2? Why not 1 and 2? Why? Because first and second steps are the commented. Commented steps will not be executed and you cannot see it on the tracer. Only the uncommented steps you will be, it will be executed and you can see it in the tracer. So the third step. Okay, in the third step, property set. Okay, that is the method we used, right? Property set. Okay, set. Okay, if you select this step method in the property set, okay, you will be seeing something called parameter page name unnamed. Click on that. See, here you can see the price and quantity.
Okay.
So the parameter values you can only see in the tracer even in the tracer also, where exactly on that particular step, okay, on that particular method, if you click on that, you can see. Okay, select the property set and then unnamed. Okay, so you should get one doubt. What is that?
That 200. We can't able to see that.
Exactly. What happened to 200? Where is that total? Why it is not showing? Why? Because that is not a parameter. That is a local variable again. I hope everyone remember. Under the parameter, we have specified quantity and price. But this total is a local variable. So local variable not showing. Then how to see local variable also? Means I go to the tracer settings. Under the settings, you have something called local variables. Now, okay. So clear it and then run it again. Okay. Execute it, close it, go to the tracer. Under the tracer, same thing, property set. Under the property set, you see, under the unnamed, you will be seeing the parameter values. But under the unnamed, earlier we were not having these view variables. Okay, after selecting the checkbox, now you got view variables also. Select this view variable. Now you can see the local variables. Can someone go on mute, please? Okay, thank you. So like this, the local variables you can see here. Okay, on the see properties on page local variables, total equal to 200. Like this. So view variables for seeing the local variables and the unnamed page for seeing the parameter values. Local variables and parameter page name. So how exactly we can see that? By selecting on the settings tracer. Here we have something called local variables checkbox. Then only you can see the local variables also. Where you can see these local variables otherwise parameters? On that particular step, where exactly you are performing the operation. Step method, click on it. And then you can see unnamed and then view variables. Okay. So that's all about the tracer. So any doubts?
No, we are clear.
Okay, great. Yeah. Then let's wind up. So tomorrow we will be having the class. So is anybody want to leave like Christmas?
No.
Okay, great. So tomorrow, yeah, that is fine. So tomorrow what I want to do is, I want to perform something called cascading. Okay, cascading means what? For example, on the work object, okay, we are seeing the states and cities, right? So what I want to do is on click of the state, like Andhra Pradesh, I want to have the drop-down for city. And in the city drop-down, I want to list out all the cities belongs to that particular state. In case if I go to the Telangana, I want to list out all the cities from Telangana. So that is called cascading. Cascading means on change of the one value in the drop down, the second drop down value should be populated. Okay, second drop down value should be populated. So this we will learn how to do it. Okay, cascade drop down population of the values.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cascading drop down.
Exactly. Okay. Then have a good day. Bye bye. Let's meet tomorrow.
Yeah, thank you. Bye.
This conference will now be recorded. This conference will now be recorded.